homework to do before we start that. We have an exit right here, an exit over there, and if you go out toward the restrooms, there's another exit to the back. The room is filled with police officers and firefighters. So we've got the firefighters staying by that door. If the guy next to you has a gun, don't be alarmed. When police officers are off, they carry weapons. So it's nobody in here with a weapon that isn't a police officer. I guess that's a better way to put it. Public comment for our city charter is 4 minutes per person, not to exceed 30 minutes, and that's at the discretion of the council. Myself and the council have decided tonight we're not going to go beyond the 30 minutes because 45 would not be any more just than 30. It would probably end up being 2 hours or 3 hours. Please keep in mind that we have to do the business of the city tonight as well. When you do come up to the podium, we're going to do it by a show of hands, and I'll select you and have you come up. And a lot of you I know, a lot of you I don't know, and I don't know who's for, who's against, who's got what to say. The order that I call you will have one timer running for 30 minutes. The city attorney will have a timer running for 4 minutes. When that timer beeps, you don't have to climb up and go back to your seat. We're going to be gracious. We're going to continue your statement, but that means your time is up, so please proceed at a little better pace and take 30 seconds or whatever you need to wrap up.
Because I have no voice, does it project loud enough for everybody to hear?
Can't hear you.
It's not really that loud back here.
Okay, how's that? A little bit better. I lost my voice about 2 weeks ago, and this is the best it gets, so I apologize if you can't hear me very clearly. Mayor, members of the council, my name is Jim Bjorn, and I live at 1063 Cooper Lake Road in Ishpeming. In February of 1965, the city of Ishpeming adopted Public Act 88, which allows employees who work for more than one city, township, or county government in Michigan to transfer years of service to qualify for a pension. Notice the law says transfer and not buyout. Last March, I requested to transfer my years Marquette County to the city of Ishpeming using Public Act 88, and I was denied by this council. For the last 39 years, the Ishpeming City Council has approved the transfer of service using Act 88 for six individual employees. Six transfers just like mine. No fuss and no problem. I'm not standing before you asking for a buyout. I only ask to be treated equally as the six previous employees in this city who used the act to transfer and combine retirement years into one fund. None of the previous transfers made under the act have been denied until now. For 39 years, this council has granted these transfers until now. There's fear of setting a precedent. Well, a precedent has been set, both in the form of a statewide public act and by this council. There are false impressions about my transfer, misinformation causing confusion. This is not taxpayer money. It's money in a retirement fund that has been paid by employees like myself and the officers and firefighters in this room into a pension fund. There's no impact on the general fund, and it will not cost the taxpayer. Well, let's talk about buyouts for just a minute. Buyouts that have cost the taxpayer. Since 1992, council has bought out or opened early retirement windows for 13 employees at the cost of $523,000, all without argument or fanfare. It's right here in black and white. Everybody has a copy. Yet my transfer is denied, and everyone asks me why. The answer is this council wants a chief that is not disabled. You want a police chief that can do the work of a patrol officer when times get tough and you start have to cutting budgets. You have to start cutting budgets. You feel I'm overpaid for what I'm able to do because of my disability. Because of my spine problems, I'm restricted to working four-hour days and administrative duties only. The city only pays me for 4 hours a day. The rest is sick leave donated by caring and compassionate employees that I work with. I have since learned of your intention, Council, to have me fired from my position, possibly as soon as September 30th, 23 days from now. And the manager said in today's paper that there's no movement afoot to fire me, but he and I have had these conversations and we both know what's going to happen if I don't come back to work full time. In 22 years of selfless service to this city, from patrolman to chief, and your interim city manager, I've been a loyal employee with an exemplary service record. I've developed ideas in our troubled financial times, including voluntary layoff, myself included, to save money and co-worker jobs. I sacrificed my family life working extra hours as your combined chief and interim city manager for 6 months. And the thanks I get is to be denied a quiet and earned retirement and to be fired. Had I been treated equally as the previous six, I would have retired in April. This would have been a non-issue. This council would be dealing with bigger issues like failing storm sewer infrastructure and other projects. By drawing out this conflict, this council will cost the taxpayers money, not my request. I want to make it clear, I don't want to retire. I have to retire because of my health. So based on the long-standing precedent repeated by this council 6 times in 39 years, never denied and covered by state law, please transfer my years so I can retire. Transfer my time and I will work with the city manager with everything needed to accomplish a seamless and uneventful transition to a new chief. I'm still willing to do the right thing. The rest is up to you. Thank you.
Mr. Edmonds?
Remember to state your name and address, please.
I will. Mr. Mayor, ladies and gentlemen of the City Council, fellow citizens, my name is Lynn Gerald. I live at 548 Poplar. I'm here to ask your help and provide assistance to one of our wounded warriors. When I was in service, I was not detailed to go into direct combat, but over time, my brother-in-law and two of my friends were in the bush, as they like to describe it. And over time, my brother-in-law was killed and two of my friends were severely wounded. We did not leave them there to rot. We took care of the wounded and we brought back my brother-in-law for burial. Police work is not unlike combat. We ask these men and women to go out and try to prevent the trouble from coming to each and every one of us. Their selfless devotion to duty is exemplary and represented in this fine man, Chief Bjorn. As a wounded man in pride and his wounded back, and he's lost his voice, the selfless service. I'll give you an example just a couple of years ago.
My name is Jerry Corkin, 108 Woodland Drive, Medani. I'm a county commissioner. Here to speak as to what the county's role was in this. Marquette County Board of Commissioners unanimously agreed to transfer Jim Bjorn's years of service from Marquette County to the city of Ishpeming. Why? Because it was the right thing to do. He has a debilitating back problem. He was an exemplary employee at Marquette County as well as in the city of Ishpeming. It's a simple matter for the city council to do the right thing and accept the years of service to Marquette County. I guess if the council members vote to fire Jim, it'll create a tremendous potential liability for the city of Ishpeming. So I urge you, it's a no-brainer. Do the right thing. accept the urge from Marquette County, which will enable Jim to retire.
My name is Rebecca Olds. I live on 812 North Pine Street. My disability is obvious. I do live with pain, not like Jim does. And it's not easy. And to have to add all of the stress that he is under because of what you people have done is, I think, a travesty.
As one of the patrol officers 27 years ago, I have not known a more dedicated, honest, hard-working, genuinely good individual ever. What Jim has given to this community, not just in Ishpeming, but in Marquette County, is incalculable. I've seen Jim's work. I've seen Jim deal with horrible situations. I've seen Jim deal with compassion with victims. I have seen Jim produce marvelous police investigations, but mostly what I've seen is a honorable man. I came down to Ishpeming one day. I needed to talk to Chief Bjorn about a case that he'd investigated that I was prosecuting. I came into City Hall. It was during the time that Jim was also being our city manager, and I asked one of the people in the building where Jim was, and the answer was, well, he's in the back. I went in the back. Jim was mopping the floor. Why? Because somebody needed to do it. That speaks volumes about Jim Bjorn and what he's done. I understand that the council has to be concerned about money. I understand that it may be that Jim cannot continue as your police chief. If you've got a patrol car that has 150 or 200,000 miles on it and the engine goes, sending it to the scrapyard makes sense. This isn't a patrol car, folks. This is a human being. And hopefully, you treat him with the dignity he deserves, and hopefully, return to him some of what he's given to you.
I am here to support Jim. I've known Jim for his entire law enforcement career. And I can honestly tell you, in that time, working with hundreds of people, I've never met anybody more dedicated, more loyal, more honorable, anywhere, even outside the law enforcement field. And my first reaction when I heard about what was happening up here was that if anybody deserves this, it's him. I've seen people with a lot less necessity retire, move on, rehire, a lot less consideration. If it doesn't work for Jim, I can't imagine working for anybody else. You know, I know Jim, like I said, for the 27 years. He's been a friend as well. I don't pick friends easily, Jim will tell you that too. But, you know, he's one of the most compassionate, loyal guys. We used to call him crazy because he was so loyal and so dedicated to this community. Not that it doesn't deserve it, I'm sorry. But, you know, all he thought about, all he cared about was Ishpeming, working the Ishpeming. Went through his struggles when he was with the county and had any decision to come back here as the police chief. That was not an easy decision. As you're well aware, Mike Lovelace was the sheriff, and he's still a sheriff today, and I imagine Jim could have maintained a very good career there and probably finished out in the same regard. But he chose to come back to Ishpeming, the community that he loves. And I would hope and urge you to reconsider your position if you were against it last time. And I hope you'd support him retiring. Thank you.